You're watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. Follow along with projects and footage with a premium download available at BorisFX.com.
We're going to talk about when it all goes wrong. Sometimes a shot just won't track, and you can't figure out why. We go through a mental checklist to see how to improve troublesome tracks. So let's talk about this. Where the track is terminated prematurely. One or more layers were not tracked properly. Mocha will give you that handy advisory when there's nothing left for you to track when an object goes off screen. I'm going to show you a quick fix for that. Track something that's moving similarly to where you're trying to track. In this case, the top of the bus is moving the same as the rest of the bus, so let's just go ahead and hit track forwards. But notice how it gets all wiggly. Well, that's not what we want. So instead, we're going to cut down on the parameters that we're tracking to just translation. Now, as we track off screen, it'll follow our object nicely off screen until there's just nothing left to track. Now, since what we're tracking is totally off screen at this point, we don't care anymore. But if we did care, we could always use manual track. So in this case, we can switch to manual track and just go to the end of our shot and move our object further down. Now we animate between that track. Now, obviously, we don't need that data because it's gone totally off screen. And there's very few times that you need to extrapolate data for an object that you can no longer see. But if you did, you would use manual track for it. Changing parameters is an extremely powerful way to get around really bad sections of track. So for instance, if I want to track this crosswalk and I try to track using this texture down here in the middle of the crosswalk instead of the crosswalk where people are walking over it. Well, in theory, that sounds like a good idea, but I've got shadows from this bus. I'm fixing to have shadows from these people, and I've got lights moving through this section. That's really going to mess up my texture data that Mocha's looking for, because remember, Mocha's looking for a consistent pattern of pixels throughout the whole shot. It doesn't help that the jitter in this shot is out of control either. So what are some of the ways I could keep that from slipping as much? Well, the first thing I would try is I would go back to where I only have good data left, and I'd start cutting down on the parameters. So translation, scale, and rotation only. Now when I hit track forwards, we've changed the algorithm in Mocha. So we're not looking as much for that skew data as we would be if we had perspective or shear on. This does mean that you would sacrifice some of your tracking quality for a more correct motion. But the good news is you can always go back and do an adjust track over the top to correct for any sort of drift that we encounter from not using the perspective or shear data. Another way to increase your track accuracy is to turn your search area from auto to something manual, and you can crank these values up. They're pixel values, so 805 is 805 pixels, and that means we're looking 805 pixels in one way or the other, and vertically 574. So if you've got an object that's rotating quickly or moving quickly or zooming quickly, you can change your rotation values, your zoom values, or your search area values. And that will actually give you a much more accurate track if you're starting to lose your data. And if all else fails, go to File, Preferences, GPU, disable your GPU processing, and restart Mocha. And that will change the algorithm that Mocha is using because Mocha uses GPU processing, and GPU processing is a little bit like skipping steps in math. Sometimes when you skip those math steps, it turns out you needed them. So you can go back to the chunk along and get every single number in order by using the CPU processing instead of GPU. And you do have to restart Mocha if you're using the standalone, and Mocha and the host if you're using the plugin. Finally, let's look at the track that I used in the previous example, adjust track. You can see that I'm avoiding this biker. I'm avoiding headlights. I'm avoiding any light changes over here and shadows. But notice my track is not very good. because I'm only using a very small amount of texture data to track. The more texture data you use in Mocha, the more accurate your track. So when you have to sacrifice texture data in the name of occlusions, reflections, and shadows, you're going to have to use adjust track to compensate for that. Now, most of the time, your shot will not be this busy. And when your shot is really busy, you can use occlusion layers. For example, if I wanted to track this crosswalk and the bus was moving over it, but I wanted as much texture as possible before the bus got there, I could take my shape layer and expand my shape. When I expand my shape, I want to make sure that I leave enough of the bus inside of the shape that it also grabs the bus shadow. We can make any adjustments that we need to our roto. Now, if I try to track this crosswalk, I can move it underneath my bus layer. Now, when my bus moves over my crosswalk texture, the top shape will be held out of the shapes beneath it. And that's basic Mocha workflow, and we've talked about that before. So, what do we do when it all goes wrong? We use occlusion mats. We look for areas where there are no occlusions. We make sure that there's no lighting changes or reflections moving over the texture that we're trying to track. We look for shadows that could be moving over the area that we're trying to track. Just because you don't see a lighting change or a shadow does not mean that Mocha is not registering the change in the texture. And we look for things like motion blur moving over the area that we are trying to track. And if all else fails, it may be that you need a lens correction on your shot. So look for lines that you know should be straight and see if they're curved. If they are, then see our lesson on lens distortion. So we talked about what to do when objects go off screen, when to use manual track, the power of changing parameters, working with the search area, and when you want to switch to GPU or CPU tracking. We also talked about what you should be tracking. And now Ben Brownlee is going to walk you through an introduction to the world of rotoscoping.
You've been watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. To download all videos, projects, and footage, purchase the premium version, available at borisfx.com.